Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and I'm back answering questions on videos, trying to catch up. Just so many comments and questions out there, and I've just been reading through them because I like it. And as I see them and as they pop up, when I have time, I will answer these questions. This is two comment question kind of things on a video I did 3 years ago, why Power BI loves the star schema. So the first one said, you forgot one obvious reason, normalization. Break that stuff apart, man. Update a single row in a dim table and all facts are changed just once. So if I have like a customer dimension and a fact table and I need to change a customer last name for a particular customer, maybe I just update one row. But if I have all of my customer attributes in my flat table and that customer's made, let's say, lots of online purchases, I may have to update hundreds, thousands, even millions of rows. The update would be much, much slower and much more intrusive, and I could probably mess some stuff up. Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my laptop. Let me show you what I'm talking about. For example, let's go over here to manage the studio. If I just had one big flat table, kind of like this, right, with all my columns and all my rows, and I wanted to run an update on one of these, right, and I just did a top 100, but there's about a million rows in this table. I'd run this update that looked like this, and it'd be lots of rows, depending on how many sales this particular customer made, and I can mess something up. But if I normalize and take all those common attributes for dim customer and put it in its own table and create a one-to-many relationship between the customers on the one side and the fact tables on the other side, so one customer can have many sales, I only update that single customer, as opposed to updating several rows. If you're tracking history, if you're doing a slowly changing dimension, where every time there's an update, you're gonna add another row. You could update a few more rows, but not as many rows as you would update if all those attributes were in the fact table. Great comment, I did miss it. So it's five reasons, I think the other video had four. The next comment, I really like this one. Great explanation on what is best practice, but I play devil's advocate for just a minute. Someone could counter your organization reason by saying, just to create folders. Just pull out the date table, just the date table, because my performance problem in the initial video was because I used a date and I did a calculation, I think it was year to date or something like that, and it was slow with the big flat table as opposed to the star schema. Pull that out and just use folders to organize everything. Let me show you. And so what I did was I created this big flat table and I grouped everything in folders, and then I created a dim date and added a relationship. This is what I think they're talking about. And they're like, look, you probably still have pretty good performance for all those time-based calculations. So I'm like, well, let's test it out. In addition to this, I'm gonna show you the test in a second, but I also created a star schema. So just like in the other video, I wrote some DAX. And so you can see this one's against the star schema, very similar to what I did in the other video. Same thing here. This one's connected to the flat table. If you look at the server time, it's about 7 milliseconds to run this one. Not much going on in the formula engine or the storage engine. There's not that much data. And the same thing here, right? 5 milliseconds. But if I ran these queries over and over again, they averaged out to about the same performance. You may be thinking, Patrick, he got you. Yeah, it's not just about the performance. Now, performance is important, but what about other factors like refresh time, which I talked about in the other video? And then another factor that I did not talk about was model size, right? I created these two models and then I used Phil C. Marks on DAX.tip analyze my refresh. And you can see right here, it took analysis services about 5 seconds to start gathering the data, but then it took 3 minutes and 59 seconds to process the data, to run all the algorithms, to do the compression and everything that it does to get it into memory. It took 3 minutes and 59 seconds for less than a million rows. So overall, it took 4 minutes and 7 seconds to refresh it, and it only processed 4,068 rows per second. I mean, you think that's pretty fast, you know? Let's go take a look at when I had my star schema. You can already see, right? It took 38 seconds. It was processing 28,292 rows per second, about the same amount of time, actually faster to get the data. And then for analysis service to do all its work, only 34 seconds. Now, if 4 minutes is okay for you and you're not concerned about your data volumes growing, you don't want to future-proof your model, don't worry about it. This approach may work, but what you also need to think about, if you
you start bringing other attributes into your DAX that are in that fact table, that very large fact table, it could affect performance. I didn't test these scenarios out. You may see a little bump in the time on the DAX queries with the flat table, but as that data grows, you need to be careful. But I'm not done. One more thing, check this out. So I opened up DAX Studio, which I had not been in a long time. You saw me run the queries, but I did a little VertiPack analyzer. So let's go check out the big flat table. So we go to VertiPack analyzer and you can see there's 138 columns and 61 megs. Not tremendous. Remember, this is just a million rows. But if I go over to my star schema and go to VertiPack analyzer, only 35 megs and actually a few more columns. Refresh time, model size, those are two big factors, especially when you're trying to stay in the guardrails or the limits of your pro license, your premium per user license, or even your premium license. What do you think, right? Are you gonna use the folder method? Are you gonna start normalizing? You gotta think about all these things when you wanna design your model and look forward to the future as your data grows. All right, you got any questions, comments? Keep them coming, you know what to do. Post them in the comments below. If you wanna learn more about Fabric, I got excited. You wanna learn more about Fabric or Power BI? Probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.